Good evening, guten Abend allerseits. Sorry.
Let's open with a prayer.
Lasst uns mit Gebet anfangen.
Dear
Heavenly Father,
thank you for this day that we could have.
And please bless this study that we would be able to understand everything. And please help us if there's anything that we don't understand that we would ask questions. And we honor and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
All right. So I posted the notes in the livestream group.
Also, es gibt Notizen in der Livestream-Gruppe.
And we will not read every quote tonight, like in the sense that we read the whole quotes, but we will go through the specific points.
Okay. Und heute Abend werden wir nicht jede Einzelheit in jeder Zitat lesen, sondern wir werden bestimmte Punkte herausziehen.
Okay, so we'll speak a little bit about the government of heaven.
So wir wollen ein bisschen über die Regierung des Himmels sprechen.
And we'll see how what happened in the heavens back then is a parallel to what is happening now before our eyes. Okay.
Und wir werden sehen, dass was damals in den Himmel geschehen ist, ist eine Parallel zu das, was gerade jetzt vor unseren Augen geschieht.
And therefore we can understand already the outcome of this war that is going on at the moment.
So, deswegen können wir jetzt schon bereits verstehen der Ergebnis diesen Krieg, der gerade stattfindet.
And as I understand, therefore, that Trump is going to win.
So, okay. Ich verstehe es deswegen, dass Donald Trump wird dieses Kampf gewinnen.
Okay, so let's remind ourselves of some principles.
So lasst uns zuerst an einigen Prinzipien erinnern.
Okay. So first of all, this point about open rebellion.
So zuerst diesen Punkt über offenes Rebellion.
Okay, and now when we turn in our Bibles to Revelation chapter 11.
Und wenn wir in unseren Bibeln zur Offenbarung 11 gehen.
Revelation 11 and then verse 7.
Offenbarung 11 und Vers 7.
7 and 8.
7 und 8.
And when they shall have finished their testimony, the beast that descendeth out of the bottomless pit shall make war against them and shall overcome them and kill them, and their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. So what are these verses speaking about historically?
Worüber sprechen diesen Versen in der Geschichte?
Yes, the French Revolution.
Französische
right?
Revolution.
The South rising up.
Also das right? Süden, die aufkommt.
Okay. So, and it says here, it's called spiritually, what, according to verse 8? Yes, Sodom and Egypt.
Right? Also es sagt hier, dass es geistlich Sodom und Ägypten genannt ist.
Okay, so let's go now to the quotes.
So, lasst uns jetzt zu den Zitaten.
Let's just read the bold-faced.
Und wir lesen nur das Fettgedruckte.
It says here, the great city in whose streets the witnesses are slain and where their dead bodies lie is spiritual Egypt. No monarch ever ventured upon more open and high-handed rebellion against the authority of heaven than did the king of Egypt. So what kind of rebellion did he have?
So was für eine Art Rebellion hatte er?
Open rebellion.
Right? Offenes Rebellion.
Open and high-handed rebellion.
So right? Offenes und ja, in dein Gesicht Rebellion.
And he basically also said, then who's the Lord? I don't know, Jehovah's. Jehovah, right?
Im Grunde hat er gesagt, wer ist der Herr? Ich kenne Jehovah nicht.
And then she says in the next bold face, this is atheism.
Und in der nächsten okay. Fettgedruckten, dies ist das Atheismus.
So here we have therefore the south.
So hier haben wir den Süden.
Because Egypt was the south, right?
Und Ägypten war den Süden.
And this is this open rebellion.
Das ist diese offene Rebellion.
And this atheistic spirit.
Und das ist dieser atheistische Geist oder Gedankengut.
And just notice, atheism doesn't mean that you don't worship any God, but it just means you deny the true God.
Und gedenke, dass Atheismus heißt nicht, dass du keinen Gott glaubst, sondern dass du nur verneinst den wahren Gott.
That denies true God. Okay, so let's just and we understand this was, then she says in the next boldface, fulfilled by France and the Revolution.
So, in den nächsten Fett gedruckt, sie sagt, das würde erfüllt durch Frankreich während der Revolution.
Okay, now jump down to the next quote.
So, jetzt kommt bis zum nächsten Zitat hinab.
And this is a quote by the pioneers in the appendix of the Great Controversy. We know this quote also.
Und das hier ist ein Zitat von den Pionieren in den Anhang von Großen Kampf. Diesen Zitat kennen wir bereits.
And where they speak about the dragon, the beast, and the false prophet.
Da sprechen sie über das Drachentier und falschen Prophet.
Okay, just jump down to the bold-faced.
Aber kommt hinab bis zur fettgedruckten Schrift.
It says, but there came a time when paganism in the Roman Empire fell before the advancing form of Christianity. Then, as is stated on page 54 of the Great Controversy, paganism had given place to the papacy. The dragon had given to the beast his power and his seat and great authority. That is, Satan then began to work through the papacy just as he had formerly worked through paganism. But the papacy is not represented by the dragon because it is necessary to introduce another symbol in order to show the change in the form of the opposition to God. Okay, so the dragon was representing what form of opposition?
Also der Drache stellte welche Art von Widerstand dar?
Yes, we haven't come to this point, but it says here the dragon made place for the papacy, right?
Also der Drache machte Raum für den Papst.
And the dragon was?
Und der Drache war?
Paganism.
Heidentum.
Yes. Okay. So paganism made place for the papacy.
Das right? Heidentum machte Raum für den Papst.
So let's continue.
Also weiterlesen.
Previous to the rise of the papacy, opposition to the law of God had been in the form of paganism. God had been openly defied, but from that time the opposition was carried on under the guise of professed allegiance to him. Okay, so here we again have paganism was what kind of rebellion?
Here haben wir wieder Heidentum war was für eine Art Rebellion?
Open rebellion. Right?
Offenes Rebellion.
So therefore, the dragon is the south. Right?
So deswegen der Drache ist der Süden.
Okay.
Oder der Süden macht.
Yes?
Amen?
Okay. So that's the dragon. Open rebellion.
Offenes okay. Rebellion.
So, okay. We can jump down to now the next bit under the heading The Glorious Land.
So, wir kommen zum nächsten Übertitel, also das herrliche Land. Psalm 105.
Yes, Psalms 105, beginning in verse 42 to 45.
Psalm 105, Verse 42 bis 45.
Says, for he remembered his holy promise and Abram his servant. And he brought forth his people with joy and his chosen with gladness, and gave them the lands of the heathen. And they inherited the labor of the people, that they might observe his statutes and keep his laws. Praise ye the Lord. So why did the Lord bring them to the promised land?
So warum hat der Herr sie zur verheißenen Land geführt?
Yes, but according to these verses.
So wegen seiner Verheißung, ja, aber wegen diesen Versen hier.
In verse 45.
Vers 45.
Yeah, that they were able to worship him freely, right?
So seine Gesetze einzuhalten, so dass sie ihm freilich anbeten konnten.
Okay, and how is this promised land also called in the Bible?
Und wie ist dieses verheißene Land auch genannt in der Bibel?
Canaan, yes.
Also Canaan, yes. Der herrliche Land.
Okay, so it's Canaan, it's the glorious land, right?
Es ist Canaan, es ist der herrliche Land.
And the characteristic of the glorious land is that they could worship God freely.
Und der Charaktermerkmal des herrlichen Landes ist, dass sie Gott freilich anbeten konnten.
Okay. And we understand eventually what does the Canaan back then typify at the very end of the world.
Und Kanan damals, was schattet es am Ende der Welt voraus?
Ten nations, the whole world.
Yes, the whole world.
Also right? Der gesamten Welt.
Okay, but that's at the perfectly fulfilled at the very end, right?
Und das ist vollkommen ganz am Ende erfüllt.
When we go for instance to Daniel chapter 7, let's just go there.
Wenn wir zum Beispiel zu Daniel Kapitel 7 gehen, lass uns dahin.
Let's read verse 26 and 27.
Die Verse 26, 27.
Says, but the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and to destroy it unto the end. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. And so here we can see the whole world will be given to the saints.
So hier können wir sehen, die ganze Welt werden den Heiligen gegeben.
Okay, but this judgment, the final judgment was typified when?
Also dieses Gericht, dieses finale Gericht hier war durch, oder wann wurde es vorausgeschickt?
How many beasts do we have here?
So wie viele Tiere haben wir hier?
Daniel
7.
Four beasts, right?
Vier Tiere.
And historically, this leads you down to where?
Und historisch führt das dich wohin?
Yes, so it's a parallel to the statue, right?
Zum vierten, also es ist ein Parallel zur Statue.
And what happens with the statue at the end?
Und was geschieht mit der Statue am Ende?
Yes, so the stone comes and hits.
Also der Stein kommt.
So
und trifft es.
And when did the statue end historically?
Und historisch, wann ist der Statue ein Ende gekommen?
Yes, 1798.
1798.
Right? Okay, so 1798, the judgment came upon the statue.
So 1798 statue. Kam das Gericht auf der Statue.
Statue. So therefore, what was then given to the saints of the Most High?
So then, was war den Heiligen des Allerhöchsten gegeben?
Yes, the land, right?
Also das Land.
Just like it says here in verse 26 and 26.
Genau so wie es hier in Vers 26, 27.
So, United States of America becomes the next world power.
Amen.
1798, der USA ist der nächste Weltmacht geworden.
So 1798, the power that rose up was the United States.
1798, der Macht, der aufgekommen ist in dieser Zeit, war den USA.
So this was the land given to God's people back then.
Und dies, okay? Geschichtlich, war das Land, die Gottes Volk gegeben worden ist.
Typifying the whole earth here at the end when the saints possess the whole earth.
Und er schattet die gesamte Erde am Ende der Welt, wenn den Heiligen den gesamten Erde erben.
And back then in the glorious land, right, was given to God's people so that they could worship God freely.
Und damals, okay? Die verheißene Land oder das herrliche Land wurde Gottes Volk gegeben, so dass sie freilich anbeten konnten.
Just like the United
States. Like the United States.
Genauso wie den USA. Yeah. Er schattet den Welt voraus.
Yes. So, United States, when it came up like a lamb, had two horns.
So den USA, als es aufkam, kam es auf wie ein Lamm und hat zwei Hörner.
And everybody could go, worship God there freely.
Und jeder, okay, konnte Gott freilich anbeten.
So therefore in 1798.
So deswegen 1798.
The United States is the glorious land.
USA ist das herrliche Land.
Okay. And at the end, when everybody gets judged and punished, then the whole world will also be a free place where everybody can worship God freely.
Okay. Am Ende, wenn die gesamte Welt gerichtet und bestraft wird, dann wird die ganze Welt ein Ort sein, wo jeder freilich Gott anbeten kann.
Okay, but the earthly Canaan back then, what did it also typify?
Das irdische Kanaan damals, was hat es noch vorausgeschattet?
Heavenly Canaan. Yes, the heavenly Canaan.
Also das himmlische Kanaan.
Okay, so it illustrates the heavenly kingdom. Okay. So
stellt das himmlische Königreich dar.
Who was their king?
Wer war deren König?
Yes, Christ.
Christus.
Okay. So now let's go to Daniel chapter 2. So
lasst uns jetzt zu Daniel Kapitel 2 gehen.
Yes. Okay, so Daniel chapter 2.
Daniel 2.
And let's read verse 21.
Und Vers 21.
Daniel 2, verse 21 says, and he changes the times and the seasons, he removeth kings and setteth up kings. He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding. So what does the Lord do with kings?
So was tut der Herr mit Königen?
Takes them down, sets them up.
Yes, takes them down, sets them up. Okay.
Nimmt sie ab und stellt sie auf.
Now let's go to Psalms chapter 2.
Jetzt Psalmen Kapitel 2.
Let's read verse, just let's begin in verse 1.
Fangen Vers 1 an.
And let's read down to verse, verse 8.
Und wir lesen bis Vers 8.
Okay. Why do the heathen rage, and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord, against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder, and cast away the cords from us. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh, the Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath, and vex them in his sore displeasure. Now verse 6. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. So what did the Lord do?
Was tat der Herr? Verse 6.
Took the crown off them and given it to the one who has raided us.
Yes, exactly.
Die Krone genommen von die und es gegeben den, dessen Recht es ist.
So here we can see that the Lord set up now his king.
So hier können wir sehen, dass der Herr seinen König aufrichtet.
Okay, and perfectly, who is it referring to? I mean, it's illustrating God's people, when they receive the crown.
Also natürlich stellt es Gottes Volk dar, wenn die Krone erhalten, aber wem stellt es perfekterweise dar?
Okay.
Offenbarung 19.
All right, so we're just going to go
there. Because
which verse do you want?
Verse 15 and 16.
Die Verse 15 and 16.
It says, and out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, and with it he should smite the nations. This is what you're referring to, right? Yes. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and the wrath of the Almighty God. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Yes.
This is Christ.
Yes, amen. Okay, so we can see the Lord set up Christ as the king. Okay.
Wir sehen hier das der Herr Christus als König aufrichtet.
Okay, so and we saw right, the glorious land back then. He set up Christ as king.
So das herrliche Land damals, der hat Christus als König aufgerichtet.
So Christ is king.
Christus ist König.
Just like in the heavens back then in the heavenly Canaan, right?
Damals wie im Himmel, in der himmlische Kanaan.
Christ was the king that the Lord put in place.
Christus war der Herr, oder der König, den den Herr eingesetzt hat.
Okay, so now let's go to Isaiah chapter 14.
Lasst uns jetzt zu Jesaja 14 gehen.
Everybody can follow so far?
Kann jeder folgen?
Isaiah 14 and let's read verse 12 to 14.
Jesaja 14, die Verse 12 bis 14.
Says, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of God, I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds, I will be like the Most High. So where did Lucifer want to sit?
So wo wollte Lucifer sitzen?
He wanted to be king of kings.
Yes, amen. He wanted
to
be
king König of kings. Der Könige werden.
And he wanted to sit in the north.
Und okay? Wollte in den Norden sitzen.
So he wanted to occupy the place of Christ, right?
Ja, wollte den Stelle von Christus einnehmen.
And Christ was the king that the Lord set up.
Und der Christus war der König, der den Herrn aufgerichtet hat.
But Satan came now and said, I want to be in this place. Okay.
Und dann kam Satan und meinte, ich möchte diese Stelle einnehmen.
So, therefore you had Christ as the king of the north, right?
Du hast Christus ist der König des Nordens.
And Satan who came against him.
Und Satan, der gegen ihn aufkam.
He's this dragon, he's the Egypt, right?
Ist diese Drache, Ägypten.
And he's the south.
Und er ist den Süden.
Okay, so therefore, what could you see in heaven? What did take place?
So deswegen, was konntest du im Himmel sehen? Was ist stattgefunden?
A rebellion.
Eine
right?
Rebellion.
Revolution.
And, yes, and what? Who pushed against whom?
Und wer kam gegen wem auf?
The south, yeah. Against the north.
The south pushed against the north. Der right?
Süden ist gegen den Norden gestoßen.
1848. Yes.
1848.
Okay. So, but eventually. Who won the war?
Aber wer hat den Krieg letztendlich gewonnen?
The North. The North, right?
The Norden.
So the North retaliates with horsemen and ships and chariots, right?
So den Norden kommt zurück mit Pferde und Streitwagen und viele Schiffen.
Okay, so and this is what I want to look at now with you guys.
Das ist das, was wir jetzt zusammen anschauen.
Because I think this is like what we see at the moment between Trump and Biden, it's like a play out of this what happened back then.
Das ist das, was wir gerade sehen können zwischen Trump und Biden. Es ist wie ein Ausspiel, was damals bereits geschehen ist.
In some sense, Trump is illustrating Christ, the King that the Lord put in place in the glorious land.
So in gewissen Weisen, Trump stellt Christus dar, also der König, den den Herrn aufgestellt hat in den herrlichen Land.
But
as long as he remembers the warning.
Yes.
Solange, dass er die Warnung wahrnimmt.
Like Nebuchadnezzar.
Yes. Nebuchadnezzar. Mm.
But Satan is the one who tries to usurp this position.
Aber okay. Satan, der ist derjenige, der möchte ungerechterweise diesen Platz einnehmen.
Just, yes, like unrechtmäßige okay. Machtergreifung. Ja. Yeah, just like Biden wants to usurp now Trump's legal election. Okay.
So genauso wie Biden, also das das Wahlkampf von Trump stehlen möchte.
Yes. Okay. So.
And then it says, so Satan was rebuked, but then it says there was war in heaven.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes. Also Satan war getadelt, aber dann gab es Krieg in den Himmel. Yes.
Anyway. So let's look at this a little bit closer.
So, lasst uns das etwas näher betrachten.
Okay, here on page number 5.
So, auf Seite Nummer 5.
Yeah, just some quotes. I think most of us are familiar with these quotes.
So, Zitaten, die meisten von uns sind vertraut damit.
Where it says, for instance, here, the United States has been a refuge for the oppressed. It has been spoken of as the bulwark of religious liberty. God has done more for this country than for any other country upon the sun, upon which the sun shines. And then also next quote, the United States is a land that has been under the special shield of the omnipotent one. God has done great things for this country.
This is a site of fear in meiner Notiz.
So, yeah, it's like this special land, this glorious land that the Lord gave to his people in 1798.
Das ist ein besonderes Land, die der Herr sein Volk 1798 gab.
Yes, and we can also see it's a refuge city.
Und wir können auch sehen, dass es gleich ein Zufluchtsstadt ist.
Because let's read the next quote, the bold-faced.
So, nächsten Zitat, das fett gedrückt.
Among the Christian exiles who first fled to America and sought an asylum from royal oppression and priestly intolerance, were many who determined to establish a government upon the broad foundation of civil and religious liberty. Okay, so here we see they fled to this refuge city, to this heavenly Canaan.
So hier können wir sehen, die sind geflüchtet zu dieser Zufluchtsstadt, diese himmlische Kanaan.
Yes, everybody can see and follow.
Kann jeder das sehen?
Okay. Because now let's jump down to the next bold-faced.
Nächste fett gedruckte.
And the Constitution guarantees to the people the right of self-government. So what is she speaking about?
So worüber spricht sie hier?
The Constitution.
Verfassung.
Okay. So we have here the US Constitution also playing a major role, right? So
hier haben wir den US-Verfassung, die eine Hauptrolle einnimmt.
Okay. And it's also the US Constitution involved in this current affair between Trump and Biden.
Und ist der US-Verfassung gerade am Spiel zwischen diesem Kampf zwischen Biden und Trump?
Yes, it's like
Satan is usurping it.
Yes.
Und Satan versucht es unrechtmäßig zu verändern.
If Biden wins, this is gone. Okay.
Also wenn Biden hier gewinnt, also der Verfassung ist vorbei.
Yeah. So. Because it says here, the Constitution guarantees the people the right of self-government, providing that representatives elect by the popular vote shall enact and administer the laws. Freedom of religious faith was also granted, every man being permitted to worship God according to the dictates of his conscience. Now, so it's this point here about the glorious land that everybody could worship God freely.
Also dieser Punkt hier über das herrliche Land, wo jeder Gott freilich anbeten konnte.
And this was given by the Constitution.
Das würde durch die Verfassung ermöglicht.
Okay, and then it says Republicanism and Protestantism became the fundamental principles of the nation. Okay, so when Christ is the North, what is he?
So wenn Christus das Norden ist, was ist er? Republicanism.
Yes, he's a Republican. Okay.
Christus ist ein Republikaner.
But in the truest sense.
Aber in den wahrsten Sinn.
That's why it has to be a Republican president.
Amen.
Deswegen muss es ein republikanisches Präsident werden.
Okay. And who would be Satan?
Und Satan ist was?
Biden.
Yes, he's a Democrat, right?
Biden. Ja, der ist Demokrat.
Communist, socialist, dictator.
Also ein kommunistisches, sozialistisches Diktatur.
Okay, because he's this open rebellion, this open defiance against God. Right?
Er ist diese offene Rebellion, dieser offene Widerstand gegen Gott.
And we can see this manifesting among the Democrats. Right?
Wir können das unter den Demokraten manifest zu sehen.
There are cities, for instance, Seattle. You just look at what's happening in Seattle. Also there's no law and order.
Also deren Städte, Seattle zum Beispiel. Yeah. Also das ist eine Demokratenstadt, es ist klar zu sehen, dass da keine Gesetz und Ordnung gibt.
Es ist absolut Chaos.
Totale Anarchie.
Yes, amen. And also Biden, he wants to take away in God we trust, if I understood it correctly, right?
Biden möchte aus dem Grundsatz in Gott wir vertrauen wir entfernen.
Yeah, he's in the bed with China, which is the dragon.
Yes.
Und Biden, der ist in... Also Kohorts mit China, und China ist natürlich symbolisch der Drache.
Okay, so and they are supporting Antifa and Black Lives Matter and all these guys.
Unterstützen diese Antifa und communists. Black Lives Matters, also diese kommunistische Gruppen.
Okay, but we understand, right, Christ, he's truly a Republican, as it was put in place back then in 1798.
Aber wir verstehen, dass Christus, er ist wahrlich ein Republikaner, so wie es aufgestellt worden ist 1798.
But at the Sunday law, What kind of republicanism will be there?
Aber am Sonntagsgesetz, was für ein Republikanismus wird da sein? A fallen one.
Yes, an apostate. There will be apostate republicanism and apostate Protestantism.
Es wird ein abgefallener Republikanismus und eine abgefallene Protestantismus geben.
The difference is that they are deceived by the woman.
Yes. Also der Unterschied ist, dass beide sind verführt von der Frau.
Because they think what they're doing is right. This is the point. They really believe what they're doing.
Die glauben vom ganzen Herzen, dass das, was sie tun, ist eben recht oder gerecht.
Yes. Whereas the Biden camp know that they're liars and cheats, yes. And they know that everything they're doing is to completely corrupt.
Yes.
Wodurch auf der anderen Seite die Lager von Biden, die wissen, dass sie durch Betrug da sind, wo sie sind. Die wissen, dass alles, was sie tun, ist auf Lüge und Betrug gebaut.
Yes. Because when we go. Just remind ourselves in John 16 when we turn there.
So in Johannes 16, wenn wir da hingehen, zur Erinnerung. Johannes 16.
Verse 1-3.
Die ersten drei Versen.
It says here, these things have I spoken unto, that ye should not be offended. They shall put you out of the synagogues, yea, the time cometh. That whosoever killeth you will think that he doeth God service. Yes. And these things will they do unto you, because they have not known the Father nor me. So they truly believe that they do a righteous work, so that they
glauben,
do the service of God.
Sie glauben wahrlich, dass sie im Dienst des Herrn ein gerechtes Werk tun.
And at the moment they do a righteous work.
Okay? Und gerade jetzt tun sie eben ein gerechtes Werk.
But when they become apostate republicanism, they still think they are Christ, but they are not Christ anymore.
Aber wenn sie abgefallene Republikanismus werden, die glauben immer noch, dass sie Christus sind, also das Werk Christi tun, aber dann ist es eben nicht mehr der Fall.
Okay, so now let's go to the next quote.
Nächste Zitat, die Notiz.
So, and we can just read the bold-faced again.
Und nur das Fettgedruckte lesen wir.
It says, it was Satan's plan to war against the God of heaven. God has a constitution. What does God have?
Was hat Gott?
Constitution.
Yes, he has a constitution.
Er hat eine Verfassung.
Therefore, the United States, typifying the glorious land in heaven, also has a constitution.
Deswegen der USA, der den herrlichen Land in den Himmel vorausschattet, hat auch eine Verfassung.
So it says here, God has a constitution and laws to govern those whom he has created. And it would be a terrible thing if any of us should be found on the wrong side, warring against the government of heaven. Okay, so, therefore, what is the US Constitution type of or a symbol of?
So, den US-Verfassung, was schattet es voraus oder was ist ein Symbol für?
Yes, the heavenly Constitution.
Das himmlische Verfassung. Right?
So, this is...
It tells us that the tree... is the symbol of a nation that upbuilds and protects people.
Also in Daniel 4, diesen Baum ist ein Symbol von einer Nation, die aufrecht hält und der Volk aufbaut, also und unterstützt.
Yes. So therefore, at the moment, right, back then Satan tried to overthrow this heavenly constitution.
So damals Satan hat versucht, diesen himmlischen Verfassung zu usurpen, also über ungerechtmäßig umzustürzen.
And this is exactly the same thing we can see at the moment.
Das ist genau dasselbe, was wir hier vor Augen sehen können.
So in the sense that now Biden is trying to overthrow this US constitution.
In diesem Sinne, dass Biden versucht, diese US Verfassung zu umwerfen.
Okay. So when we go now to the next quote.
Nächste Zitat.
Just the bold-faced again.
Das Fettgedruckte wieder.
But it is ever the purpose of Satan to make void the law of God and to pervert the true meaning of the plan of salvation. Next bold-faced.
Nächste Fettgedruckte.
He has foisted upon the world the deception that God has abolished his constitution, thrown away his moral standard and made void his holy and perfect law. So he again speaks about God's constitution.
Spricht wieder über Gottes Verfassung.
Next quote.
Nächste Zitat.
Again the bold face.
Das Fettgedruckte.
Says here, Satan began the work of rebellion in heaven by opposition to the constitution and government of God. And this is the manner of work he has carried on ever since the fall of man. Through the agency of evil men, he seeks to make void the law of the Most High. Okay, so we can see the same work that he did in heaven back then by fighting against God's constitution, he's doing now here on earth, right?
Wir können sehen, dass dasselbe Werk, die er damals in den Himmel gegen Gottes Verfassung zu kämpfen, er tut eben dasselbe hier auf Erden jetzt.
Yes. Amen. Can you see this from the quote?
Könnt ihr das aus dem Zitat erkennen?
Okay. So therefore, this is just Trump versus Biden is just a play out of the same principle.
So hier diesen Trump gegen Biden, es ist nur eine Ausspielung genau desselben Prinzip.
Because he says here, through the agency of evil man, he seeks to make void the law of the Most High. Okay, so trying to make void the law of the Most High is basically the same thing as making void the Constitution.
Right? So indem dass du das Gesetz der Allerhöchsten zunichte machst oder versuchst zu machen, ist dasselbe, wie als wenn du den US-Verfassung zunichte machen möchtest.
Okay, next quote.
Yes. Nächste Zitat.
Those who are making an effort to change the Constitution and secure law enforcing Sunday observance little realize what will be the result. A crisis is just upon us. Okay, so we can also see at the Sunday law they will also make void the Constitution.
So wir können sehen, am Sonntagsgesetz, die werden die Verfassung außer Kraft setzen.
Okay, and we come to this point a little bit later.
Darauf werden wir gleich zurückkommen.
Okay, let's go to the next point.
Nächste Punkt.
They do not see that if a Protestant government sacrifices the principles that have made them a free, independent nation, and through legislation brings in the Constitution, principles that will propagate papal falsehood and papal delusion, they are plunging into the Roman horrors of the Dark Ages. Okay, so it's again here about the Constitution.
So, wieder handelt es sich über die Verfassung.
Okay, now let's go to the next quote, because this is interesting.
Nächste Zitat, denn hier wird es interessant.
Okay, because let's read the first paragraph.
Also der erste Absatz lesen wir.
You speak of living among Sekesh. I don't know what this is.
I don't know what this is.
I'm sorry that it is so. It is so strange that northern man can sympathize with this terrible rebellion in the institution of slavery. And she wrote this in 1862. So what is she referring to here?
Es wurde 1862 geschrieben. Also worauf bezieht sich das hier?
Yes, it's the US Civil War, right?
Der US-Bürgerkrieg.
Okay. And the US Civil War was a war between?
Der US-Bürgerkrieg, das war
North
ein Krieg
South, right?
Zwischen Norden und Süden.
Okay, next paragraph.
Nächster Absatz.
But you have never considered that there is a greater rebellion against God's government by the inhabitants of the earth, which is winked at. Satan was the first rebel. He is the great leader of all rebellions. He rebelled against the laws of God's government, framed by God himself, which were afterward written with his own finger upon tables of stone. So, in the war between the North and the South, in the US Civil War, who were the rebels?
So in das Krieg zwischen Norden und Süden, in den US-Bürgerkrieg, wer waren die Rebellen?
South. Was the South, right?
Der Süden.
Okay, so, and we looked at this, that the North illustrates the work of Christ, right?
Wir haben gesehen,
crushing down this rebellion.
Der Norden stellt das Werk Christi dar, diese Rebellion auslöschen.
And she compares this rebellion in the Civil War with the rebellion of humanity against God, right?
Und sie vergleicht diese Rebellion in der Bürgerkrieg wie der Rebellion zwischen der Menschlichkeit gegen Gott.
But also between the rebellion of Satan against God.
Aber auch in der Rebellion mit Satan, zwischen Satan und Gott.
So she basically links the US Civil War to this war between Christ and Satan here at the very beginning.
Also sie verbindet den US Bürgerkrieg zwischen diesen Krieg zwischen Christus und Satan am Anfang.
Okay. So now let's go to the next paragraph.
Nächster Absatz.
She says, we have now In this US Civil War,
also in diesem US-Bürgerkrieg,
we have now an exhibition in our land of how serious a matter it is to lightly esteem or rise up against and prove disloyal to the government or constitution of our land. Okay, so what was the South doing?
Und zwar, was hat den Süden getan? Disloyal to the government.
Yes, they rose up and proved disloyal to the government or constitution.
Sind aufgekommen und haben sich untreu bewiesen gegen den US-Regierung und der Verfassung.
Okay, are you still with me, guys?
Seid ihr immer noch da?
Okay, so there we can see, yeah, that's the very same depiction of here, same between against Christ. Right?
Können sehen, es ist genau derselbe Darstellung wie hier Satan gegen Christus.
So this US Civil War was when Satan proved disloyal against the government of God and against the heavenly constitution.
Right? So dieser US Bürgerkrieg war gleich wie Satan, der sich als untreu gegenüber Gott und der himmlischen Verfassung erwies.
Okay, and let's continue.
So, lass uns weiter.
And then consider how high a crime it must be to trample upon and despise the laws of God's government and bow to and reverence an institution of the papacy framed by the man of sin who exalted himself above God and who is the great enemy of God. Is not this the highest and most heaven-daring rebellion? Does it not deserve the highest punishment? Okay, here she links it to the Sunday law. Okay.
So here verbindet sie das zum Sonntagsgesetz.
Thank you. I've had this thought for some time. How is the, because Nebuchadnezzar is also parallel to Pharaoh, mm-hmm. and Pharaoh was the one that was enslaving the people in the U.S. Civil War, the South.
Also Nebuchadnezzar wird parallel mit Pharao gestellt, und Pharao war derjenige, der Gottes Volk in Knechtschaft oder in Sklaverei gehalten hat. Yes. Also während der US-Bürgerkrieg.
Okay, so in that sense, Satan was the Confederates, was the South, right?
In diesem Sinne, Satan war der Konföderaten, also den Süden.
But in this instance, he swapped around. He's deceived everybody, and he's now sitting in the sides of the North, and they don't know it.
Aber in diesem Fall hat er alles umgedreht. Er sitzt jetzt im Norden und keiner weiß es.
And he's going to bring them into slavery. It's the very same war, but he's sitting on the other side now, and he's totally deceiving everybody.
Aber er wird sie in der Sklaverei führen, und sitzt jetzt auf der anderen Seite, auf den Norden, und wird allen verführen.
And I think this is why Nebuchadnezzar is both Pharaoh, or should I say, the North is both Pharaoh and Nebuchadnezzar in one sense.
Und deswegen glaube ich, dass Pharao und Nebuchadnezzar sowohl das Norden und Süden im Eins sind.
Not North and South. North in one sense.
Also Nebuchadnezzar und Pharao des Norden sind im Eins.
Yes. I also thought about it because in a sense Satan, he's truly the South, right?
Weil im wahrsten Sinne habe ich auch darüber nachgedacht. Satan im wahrsten Sinne ist der Südmacht.
When you can openly see him, but when you can't see him, he's disguised.
Also wenn du ihn offen sehen kannst, aber wenn vertarnt ist, kannst du ihn natürlich nicht sehen.
Because he just assumes the form of the North, but he's still in reality is the South. Right?
Also nimmt nur das Form des Nordens an, aber der bleibt nach wie vor der Süden.
So in the sense.
That's why he speaks like a dragon. He speaks like the South.
Deswegen spricht er wie eine Drache. Er spricht wie den Südmacht.
Because he's bringing them into slavery, the same thing the South did.
Also er bringt sie in die Sklaverei, dasselbe, was den Süden getan hat.
Yes. Okay, so this point I will reconsider here. Okay. But anyways, let's just jump down to page number 11.
Lasst uns zur Seite 11 hinunterkommen. Not sure we've got the same page. Is it the last page?
No, it's in total of 14 pages.
So what's the title?
The title is the heading, The Glorious Land equals Heaven equals United States.
Also unter dem Titel, Der herrliche Land ist gleich Himmel gleich USA.
Okay, so the quote we will read.
Also der Zitat lesen wir.
So this speaks now about back then how it was in heaven.
Und das spricht jetzt damals, wie es war im Himmel.
Okay, the bold-faced.
Das fettgedrückte.
Satan was of the highest order of angels, but Christ was above all. He was the commander of all heaven. Next bold-faced.
Nächste fettgedrückte.
Satan commands to insinuate his dissatisfied feelings to other angels, and a number agreed to aid him in his rebellion. And next paragraph.
Next Absatz.
So here we could see that Christ was the one who was put in place by God.
Right? So können wir sehen, Christus war derjenige, der bei Gott eingestellt ist.
Okay, and Satan tried to now usurp his position.
Und Satan versucht, diese Position unrechtmäßig zu nehmen.
Next paragraph, it says here, true faithful angels listening hear the awful threats of Satan and immediately report to their great commander. Christ tells them that he and the Father are acquainted with the purposes of Satan and that they are forbearing only to see how many will unite with him to rebel against the government of God. So what did Christ and the Father do?
So was hat Christus und den Vater getan? This is very interesting.
Yes.
That's really interesting.
Yes, okay. So they were just, they knew all things.
Also die wussten alles, was abging.
And they were just waiting to see who's true and who's just, you know, pretending to be true.
Sie haben nur aufgehalten und gewartet, um zu sehen, wer nun mal treu ist und wer nur spielt vor, treu zu sein.
John properly says that he tests people.
Yes,
this is true. Also tests loyalty.
Trump sagt offen voraus, offen, der verbirgt es gar nicht. Also der testet die Loyalität von Menschen.
So everybody's been allowed to manifest their character now. He's just waiting.
So jeder in den USA wird erlaubt, deren Charakter zu manifestieren, und er wartet es nur ab.
So. And he basically said, whenever somebody is unfaithful, I never forget.
Yeah, der hat auch gesagt, wenn jemand untreu ist, I think he says that God will forgive them, I won't. Also er sagt es in dem Sinn, also so, ich werde deren Untreue nicht vergessen, aber ich glaube, der sagt, Gott wird es ihnen vergeben, ich nicht.
Okay, so let's continue.
Also weiterlesen.
He tells them that every purpose of Satan is understood. It was the highest crime to rebel against the government of God. So, what was it?
Was war es?
Was high treason, right?
Es war der höchste Verbrechen, das ist
Hochverrat.
Hochverrat, genau. Mm.
So in the same sense, right, what's going on at the moment in the election, it's high treason, right?
So in demselben Sinne, das was in den Wahlkampf abgeht, ist Hochverrat.
It says, it's interesting because it says in Romans 13, verse 4. For he is the minister of God to thee for good.
Yes.
But if thou doest that which is evil, be afraid, for he beareth not the sword in vain. For he is the minister of God, a revenger, to execute wrath upon them that doeth evil.
Also in Römer 13, 4 sagt, der ist eingesetzt, wenn du Gutes tut, dann hast du nichts zu fürchten. Aber wenn nichts, dann er trägt den Schwert nicht umsonst, denn er ist eingestellt, ein Rächer zu sein, diejenigen, die Böse tun.
Yes.
Im Grunde.
So, die Böses tun.
Die Böses tun.
Yes. Okay, so it was the highest crime to rebel against the government of God. All heaven seemed in commotion. So, is the United States now in commotion?
Also ist der ganze USA aufgewühlt?
The angels were marshaled in companies, each with a higher commanding angel at their head. All the angels were astir. Satan was warring against the government of God because ambitious to exalt himself and unwilling to submit to the authority of God's Son, heaven's great commander. Okay. While some of the angels joined Satan in his rebellion, others reasoned with him to dissuade him from his purposes, contending for the honor and wisdom of God and giving authority to his Son. Satan urged, for what reason was Christ endowed with unlimited power and such high command above himself? He stood up proudly and urged that he should be equal with God. He makes his boast to his sympathizers that he will not submit to the authority of Christ. At length, all the angels are summoned to appear before the Father, to have each case decided. Satan unblushingly makes known to all the heavenly family his discontent that Christ should be preferred before him to be in such a close conference with God, and he be uninformed as to the result of the frequent consultations. God informs Satan that this he can never know. And so on and so forth. And now let's jump to the next paragraph.
Next Absatz.
The Father decides the case of Satan and declares that he must be turned out of heaven for his daring rebellion, and that all those who united with him in his rebellion should be turned out with him. Then there was war in heaven. Okay, so if this repeats, then we already know what is coming. Okay.
Also wenn dies, wenn dies sich wiederholt, dann wissen wir bereits, was kommt.
So it's Daniel 11, verse 40, right?
Daniel 11, Vers 40.
So, and therefore, and it was a civil war in heaven.
Right? Es war ein Bürgerkrieg im Himmel.
So it was Christ's angels against Satan and his angels.
Christus, okay. Seine Engeln gegen Satan und seine Engel.
And thus the boldface.
Das Fettgedrückte.
Christ and loyal angels triumphed and drove Satan and his rebel sympathizers from heaven. So who's gonna win this battle?
So wer wird diesen Kampf gewinnen?
The North.
Yes, the North, right?
The Norden.
So Trump will win this.
Trump wird dies gewinnen.
Well, Christ will win it. He'll be using Trump.
Yes.
Also Christus wird es gewinnen, aber der nutzt Trump.
Dafür. So basically this thing, this election fraud is therefore just a play out of what happened here in heaven.
So dieser Wahlkampf, die gerade abgeht, ist nur eine Ausspielung dessen, was damals im Himmel abging.
And Trump is filling the role of Christ and Biden is filling the role of Satan.
Und Trump erfüllt die Rolle von Christus und Biden die Rolle des Satans.
Did it ever look like Satan would gain this position he wanted? Like now with Biden?
Hat es aber in den Himmel so ausgesehen, als Satan seine Position einnehmen würde?
I mean, first he was allowed to run freely, right? He was able to
take a look at Job. He came boldly before the throne of God.
I mean, he was allowed to, you know, do all his deceptive parts and also all the deceptions.
Anfang war es ihm erlaubt, all seine Verführungen im Himmel auszuspielen.
So in this sense, yeah, he was first on the high end, if you want to say it like this. Okay.
Er durfte zuerst gehen.
Oh, he was first on the. Er hatte den Hebel in der Hand.
Also zuerst hatte er den Hebel in den Hand.
But how okay. Would you say it in English?
I have no.
He was on the.
He was in the driving seat.
Yes, he was in the driving seat.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's. I can understand that. And that's the reason why you need to be out of the cities.
Und das ist der Grund, weshalb du aus den Städten heraus sein musst.
I mean, I think that it will hit America, obviously. Greater than all the countries, but it will spread over the world because most of the world are joined with Biden. Right? They all support all the European nations are supporting Biden. So
es wird schlimm in den USA sein, aber es wird alle Nationen treffen, denn die meisten Nationen, besonders die europäischen Nationen, sind alle auf der Seite von den Kommunisten, also von Biden.
Yes. Ellen White also says God cannot lie, and for this reason it looked bad in the beginning, because he was never lying.
Yes. Also Ellen White sagt, dass Gott nicht lügen kann, und aus diesem Grund sah es für ihn schlecht aus, weil er eben nicht lügen konnte.
Yes, at the beginning Satan was, she said, Satan could use deception and lies and all these things. And
so, sie sagt, am Anfang Satan konnte Verführung und Lügen und all diesen Sachen benutzen, die Gott nicht benutzen konnte.
The principle is always that first it looks like that the evil wins, but at the end, you know,
das Prinzip sieht immer so aus, als am Anfang, als wäre das Böse das Überhand gewinnen, aber am Ende kehrt sich das.
Okay, so therefore we can understand that basically now this war between Trump and Biden is a role play of the war between Christ and Satan in heaven.
Also wir können sehen, dass diesen Krieg zwischen Trump und Biden eine Ausspielung der Krieg zwischen Christus und Satan im Himmel ist.
And the result will be a civil war.
Und der Resultat wird ein Bürgerkrieg sein.
And Trump will remain in office.
Okay. Und Trump, der wird weiterhin im Amt bleiben.
And just one point on this question, whether it looked like that Satan was winning or not.
So auf diese Frage, ob es nun mal aussah, ob Satan nun am Gewinnen war oder nicht.
I think that it always depends which side you are standing on, because
es kommt darauf an, auf welchen Seite du stehst.
Because the angels who were supporting Satan, they believed his arguments as invalid.
Denn die Engel, die Satan unterstützte, sie haben geglaubt, dass seine Argumenten nun gültig waren.
It's the same also now in this election, the people who support Biden, they think it's valid, you know, and he's the right one, and they believe.
Dasselbe jetzt in diesem Wahlkampf, weil diejenigen, die stehen auf der Seite von Biden, die glauben, dass dann nun mal, dass das richtig ist.
The ones that were on God's side, even though they may have been shaken by, because they have never seen something like this.
Aber diejenigen, die auf der Seite des Herrn waren, obwohl sie erschüttert waren, weil sie sowas noch nie erlebt hatten,
they knew that what God's principles are, and that at the end he would turn it around so that he will make everything come to light.
Sie waren vertraut mit Gottes Prinzipien und wussten, dass am Ende Gott das alles umdrehen wird und alles ans Licht bringen wird.
Same you see also now all those people that support Trump, they say there's something that was wrong, you know, so and they hope and believe that.
Ist dasselbe wie all diejenigen, die jetzt Trump folgen, die sehen klar, dass irgendetwas daran falsch ist und sie hoffen und glauben, dass irgendetwas Gutes dabei rauskommen wird.
And also we can see also how Biden and his team, they use all the lies, right? Like Satan, he just deceived everybody and lied to everybody.
Wir können sehen, dass Biden und seine Leute, die benutzen all diesen Lügen, genauso wie Satan all diesen Lügen benutzt hat.
So there are clear parallels and we can already therefore know the outcome of it.
So klare Parallelen darin und wir können deswegen den Ausgangspunkt schon daran erkennen. So I've got a, you know, I heard today, you know, this, you know how they're going after Hunter Biden, Biden's son, right, about being in these deals with China and all the rest of it. Well, it wouldn't be in Trump's best interest to go after Hunter Biden at the moment, because if he gets Hunter Biden, he's going to get his father as well, because they were both in there. And if his father doesn't, you know, get the presidency because of this, it's instantly Kamala Harris by law who would become the president. She's even worse than Biden. But the person who was saying, he actually believes that that's the South's plan anyway. As soon as they get the presidency, they're going to chop Biden. They're going to come out with all this stuff about Hunter Biden and chop him away and get rid of him. He's just the puppet to get Kamala Harris in position. I don't know how that plays out in this story, but it's terrible. You know, it's like the woman hiding behind the puppet.
Well, okay, but you have to see that in the Bible.
So. No, okay. I agree. That's what I'm saying. I don't know how that plays in this.
Okay, then we don't need to bring that in here. Yeah.
Okay, so therefore, just to conclude, okay, so basically, the Glorious Land in 1798 was the United States.
Also das herrliche Land in 1798 war der USA.
And it illustrates the heavenly Canaan, right?
Und stellt das himmlische Kanaan dar.
Because the US Constitution is a type or a parallel to the heavenly Constitution.
Die US-Verfassung ist eine Typus oder eine Parallel zu der himmlischen Verfassung.
And in the United States, you have the king that the Lord put in place at the moment, which is Donald Trump.
Und okay. In den USA hast du den König, der den Herrn aufgestellt hat, in dem Moment, dass das Donald Trump.
And he's a Republican.
Er ist Republikaner.
Like Christ.
Wie Christus ein Republikaner ist.
And now here the South, the open rebellion, the Democrats tried to usurp this kingship.
Und hier der Süden, also die Demokraten, die versuchen diese Thron zu unrechtmäßig stürzen.
Yes. Just like Satan tried to do it with Christ.
Genauso wie Satan es mit Christus damals versucht.
In Christ he was waiting until everybody was basically made his mind up.
Und Christus hat gewartet, bis jeder sich entschieden hat.
And then eventually the war broke out. Okay.
Und dann am Ende das Krieg ist ausgebrochen.
So, and this is eventually what will also happen now in this illustration.
Okay. Das ist letztendlich, was in dieser Darstellung stattfinden wird.
So, and Christ won this civil war.
Und Christus hat diesen Bürgerkrieg gewonnen.
And therefore Trump, because he plays out the role of Christ in this illustration, he will win this civil war.
Und weil Trump die Rolle von Christus in diesen Darstellungen ausspielt, der wird diesen Bürgerkrieg gewinnen.
So, and we already predicted, right, that the South will rise up.
Und wir haben das bereits verkündet, dass den Süden aufkommen wird.
And this is just the perfect scenario now, what we see just before us.
Und das ist hier der perfekte Ausspielung, was wir gerade vor unseren Augen sehen.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Then if nobody wants to add anything, then we can close in prayer.
Wenn niemand was da hinzufügen möchte, dann können wir mit Gebet schließen.